Hi, I'm Ajith. Welcome to the video. Train collisions are still a nightmare for train passengers and their loved ones. However, things are going to change rapidly as India managed to develop a comprehensive system to prevent train collisions. Kavach is the name given to the technology. Many of you may already know this. Every time there is a train accident happens, there are discussions about this technology. It is a system that controls the train fully automatically in an emergency. So I will explain how this system works in a manner that everyone could easily understand. Those who have searched about the Kavach system know that apart from a general idea of what equipment it has and how it works, there is no video or anything on the internet that explains how exactly the system works in a real emergency. And also about this important display which informs the loco pilot about everything that happens in and around the train in real time. So this may be that first video on YouTube that fully explains the Kavach system. Let's start then. Kavach was also developed by the same government organization that designed and developed the Vande Bharat train, RDSO, which is a technology developer of the Indian Railway. Initially, the plan was to import the technology from some other country. But the fact that we have to develop a new system suited to our needs and the Indian conditions and the foreign system is too costly have brought things to the conclusion that it is better to develop it here on our own. So the development started in 2012 but only be completed in 2022. Speaking of cost, do you know how much it will cost to implement the Kavach system? 50 lakhs per kilometer. Indian Railways has a total length of 1,26,000 kilometers. Then how many crores are needed to implement the Kavach system in the entire country? About 63,000 crores. Systems have to be fitted not only on track but also on stations and locos. In 15,000 locomotives and in over 7,300 railway stations. It will take several years to install it all over India. But the 50 lakhs per kilometer cost is less than the European system. It costs rupees 2 crore per kilometer. So first, let's look at the parts of Kavach. Its equipment is mainly in three places, namely in locomotive, track and station. On the track, two tags with an RFID chip like in our fast tag will be placed at a distance of every 1 kilometer. RFID stands for radio frequency identification. It will contain some essential information and the exact location of it in this 1,26,000 kilometer. An RFID reader such as at toll gates can read that information via radio frequency. So it may be understood that this reader will be fitted in the loco. The locomotive will have RFID readers on its underside, one each at the front and back. Information from it is processed by a computer or ECU in the loco itself. The technical name of the Kavach system is TCAS or Train Collision Avoidance System. So the electronic control unit is called Loco TCAS. Next to it is the brake interface unit. This facilitates the Kavach system to apply the brake of the train by itself. This is also an electronic control unit. There are definitely some relays and mechanical parts which are not shown here. TCAS needs to know the speed of the train accurately, so it has connections from the wheel speed sensors on loco axles. There are antennas for loco TCAS to connect with TCAS units at railway stations. Communication is in the UHF band through these two radio antennas. It also has a GSM antenna, mobile signal antenna. The data in loco TCAS will be sent to the servers via the internet. I think that it is not yet at full scale. It also has a GPS antenna. This is to know the location of the train. Also, RFID does the same thing, but it can reduce failure if you make things double check, right? Moreover, the RFID tag itself is needed to know exactly which of the parallel tracks the train is currently running on and its direction. Synchronizing of time in loco TCAS also happens through GSM and GPS signals. Now, the loco pilot needs to know everything that happens in the system. That's what this display is for. Driver machine interface, also called LPOCIP, Loco Pilot's Operation Cum Indication Panel. The Kavach system has a lot of information to show on this screen, but not only that, it shows the speed limit of that part of the track and the train, which is the next signal to be seen, how far is that signal, how far is the red signal, how far is it if turning to another track, the length of the train, and so on. All necessary information for the loco pilot is present in this display. Let's understand all that in detail. Before that, let's know about the types of equipment in the station TCAS 2. The station's Kavach equipment includes station TCAS, station master's interface, GPS and GSM antennas, and a large radio tower. The UHF signals of all trains running within the range of that station should be captured. The station TCAS is connected to the signal relay of the signal system in the station. From that, the station TCAS will receive all the manual and automatic signal data. Station TCAS is the most important thing in this whole system. It will receive the location, direction, speed, and signals of many trains and process it to find out if any train is dangerously on the same track as another train and forward that message to those trains' loco TCAS. That is, it can be said that station TCAS are the brain of the system. Loco TCAS only tells the things to and obeys the commands of the station TCAS. But we feel that this LPOCIP is the face of this system because it is that communicates with us. The best way to understand the workings of Kavach is to understand what is on this screen and understand how Kavach protects the train in each situation. It shows the current speed of the train. This light green bar is the current maximum speed limit of the train. This dark green is the upcoming speed limit. That information message will be displayed here and how much distance is there for the train to reach at that speed. The same thing is shown here as the target distance. Turnout or the place where the train has to turn from this track to another track is the current target. This yellow or orange graph shows that distance. It is again in the number below. Here is the number of this train. Date and time. This blue bar is the move authority. That is for how many kilometers ahead the train is allowed to run from the station. That means there will be a red light after this kilometer. In short, move authority is the distance at which the train has to stop. It shows what the next signal is. This is the biggest convenience for the loco pilot with this display of Kavach. No suspense as to what the next signal will be. Also, no problem with missing it on the track side. Here you know in advance which one it is and how far away it is. It also shows what kind of signal it is. This is a home signal. This arrow refers to the direction of the turnout. This time it is to the left. This refers to the RFID tags on the track. The tags are at every kilometer. This green means that the tags of the last 3 kilometers have been read. The red color will appear here if any reading has been missed. This is how far away the next tag is. This shows the ID of the last red tag and the direction of the train detected from the tag reading. Now the train is running towards north. This is the range of the UHF radio signal tower, like in the mobile phone. This is about type of the control mode the Kavach system has on the train. Here it is in full supervision or fully automatic or complete control mode. This is the total length of the train. The system is capable of calculating the speed, length and weight of the train. Accordingly, how much time and how much distance is required to stop the train completely or reduce it to a certain speed. And understand the signals, speed limits and move authority by itself and warns the loco pilot at the right time. But still, if he not react, then it can control the train by cutting the throttle and applying the brakes to bring the train to the speed limit or to stop it completely. Moreover, the most important problem of all is the collision that may occur due to another train standing dangerously on the track or coming in the opposite on the same track. The Kavach will detect that and stop the train by applying the emergency brake to avoid the collision. So let's see and understand how Kavach does these things like in a simulation. Let's see how Kavach slows down the train for the turnout. Here, there is a turnout after 1300 meters. For which the speed of the train should be reduced to 30 km per hour. The loco pilot normally gets these kinds of notifications from the station through other means. Also, he can understand that from the next signal light. The train has to only run at a low speed at turnouts or track changes because it is a place where there is a chance of derailment. Now the train is running close to the maximum permitted speed. The loco pilot should start applying the brake from the time he crosses the next signal. Then he can bring the speed down smoothly to the turnout. The current speed and location of the train, tag ID and direction and many other things are reported to the station TCAS by the train TCAS through UHF signal and the required commands and information about signals, speed limit and information about turnout are sent back to the train TCAS by the station TCAS and accordingly LPOCIP will display the things and train TCAS will control the train when and how it is needed. As the closest one is a single yellow, the next one will be a red signal. And how far is that red signal can be understood from the move authority. The home signal passed. The next signal is red, but it is about 2 km away. But the distance to the turnout is only 700 meters. The speed of the train is slowing down a bit, but is still faster than needed. The distance to the turnout is now half a kilometer. Sensing that the speed is not being reduced enough, that is overspeeding, the Kavach system will first give a warning to the loco pilot. A sound like this will be heard and the speedo needle will turn orange. The speed that should have been at this time will be shown in green color, and the difference between it and the current speed will be shown in orange color. The warning that the full service brake will be applied by itself within a few seconds will also come here. If the loco pilot does not respond within 5 seconds, that is if the brake is not at all applied or is less, then the Kavach system will take over the control. The full service brake will be applied. It will show as a message here and its icon here. Speedo needle and the difference becomes red. Meanwhile, you must have missed something here. The distance to the next RFID tag is decreasing and the tag is being read and that ID is changed. By applying the brakes adequately, Kavach brought the train to a speed of 30 km per hour before the turnout. When the speed is within the limit, the needle turns white again. By releasing the brake icon also disappeared. But the next is a red light and it is about 1 km away. So its target distance has come here. It is the same as move authority. The target has become EOA, end of authority. Let's take a look at how the Kavach handles it, but at higher speeds. So let's look at another instance. The train is moving at the permitted speed of 100 km per hour of this track. It can, because the next light is green. It passed. The next light is double yellow. That means after that one will be a single yellow. There is no need to reduce the speed now. Have to do it when the loco passes the single yellow signal light. Move authority is still about 2 km. This is the distance left for the train to stop. The target bar has yet to arrive. So now everything is clear. Double yellow passed. The next signal is a single yellow, 1 km away. Immediately after passing it, the target distance appeared. End of authority, red signal. Beyond it, maybe another train standing on the track or some work may be going on the track. Whatever it is, passing a red light is dangerous. But suppose our loco pilot did not see any signal. By now, the Kavach system at the station and at the loco realizes that it is time to fully reduce the throttle and apply the brake. It first warns the loco pilot, needle and speed differences are shown in orange. It also gives a message that the brake is about to be applied, but we can assume that both our loco pilots fell asleep. After 5 seconds, the loco TCAS cut the throttle and applied full brake automatically. There is a difference of about 30 km per hour between the target speed and the current speed. But it reduced gradually and the train stopped when there was about 70 meters remaining from the red light, without any help from the loco pilot. Almost all railway accidents happen due to human error. That was also the case with the recent train accident in Bengal. A train was lying on the track and was being followed by another train on the same track. The automatic signal was also not working. So the loco pilot got authorization from the station master to pass without obeying those signals. But in that situation, there is a rule that you should not go at a speed more than 10 or 15 km per hour. And you should proceed ahead only after seeing that the track is clear. It is said that the loco pilot of the goods train did not comply with that. The passenger train was stopped on the track a little beyond the station. So the goods train crashed into it from behind. So in such a situation, even if there is no signal light, the Kavach system can recognize that a train is lying on the same track and can stop the train before that without anyone's permission and intervention. In such a train that is moving at full speed, a message arrives from station TCAS to the loco TCAS that there is another train on the same track about 1 km away. The moment the train TCAS gets that message, it cuts the throttle and applies the emergency brake without wasting time for any warning. The mission is to stop it as soon as possible. The icon of the emergency brake applied will appear here. Collision is the target here. It will be displayed here as a message so that the loco pilots can understand what is going on, and the number of the loco that is going to hit and the distance left to it. Head-on collision with loco 40302. But here the train stopped when 377 meter remained. Even if it doesn't stop in such a big gap, Kavach can definitely avoid the collision. So you may have understood Kavach's working through the pilot's point of view. There are more interesting and informative videos on the channel, so please check them out. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.